Madam Speaker, just over 11 months ago, we had an emergency debate on Gaza. And now, here we are again in another emergency debate as this conflict continues to escalate from Gaza to the West Bank and now to Syria and Lebanon. I said it then, and I say it again now, there must be a ceasefire. The violence must end. This is a very dangerous moment in world history that threatens to pull in more countries and put more innocent civilians at risk. I am very worried about this continuing pattern of escalation. From the start, my heart and my worry has been with the innocent civilians. The innocent civilians in Gaza, in West Bank, in Lebanon, and in Israel. They want no part of this war. They just want to be able to live their lives, to make a living, and to raise their children without the fear of bombing or rockets or missiles or ground invasions. This should be the right of every person, no matter where they live or call home. I visited the West Bank in January, and I met small children who go to bed every night fearful of sniper bullets. I saw the bullet holes near their bedroom windows. No one should have to grow up like this. Scarborough Center is home to a vibrant Lebanese population, and I've been on the phone and in person meetings with them nearly constantly over the past week. They are beside themselves with worry for their loved ones back in Lebanon. Communication with them has been spotty and unreliable, and as they watch the news of days of Israeli bombing that have killed hundreds, they hold their breath, waiting for a message from their loved ones so they know if they are alive or not. No one should be forced to live with this fear. No people in any country deserve this. They told me of one family in Lebanon who drove from the south to Beirut, looking for safety with their baby and small children. Israeli bombs hit the road ahead of and behind them. They say the children will forever be scared by this experience. They tell me schools are being used as shelters, gathering mattresses and food and water. With the news of today's missile attack by Iran, the pattern of escalation continues and the danger for the innocent people of the region increases. I condemn all attacks that target innocent civilians. This conflict did not begin 11 months ago. These are not the first bombings of Gaza or Lebanon. These are not the first rocket or missile attacks against Israel. The roots of this conflict are deep and they must be addressed substantially. Madam Speaker, but what must be abundantly clear is that Israel actions are not making anyone safer, not the people of Palestine, not the people of Lebanon, and not the people of Israel. Instead, this widening conflict is only making everyone more unsafe. The pattern must end. In December, Canada called for a ceasefire in Gaza. Last week, Canada joined the United States, the European Union, and 9 other allied countries in calling for a ceasefire in Lebanon. Unfortunately, last week's call for a ceasefire has been ignored, as was the one in December. Repeating the same thing that has failed again and again and expecting different results is a strategy proven to fail. It is time to move beyond statements. It's time for action. Canada must implement a clear and unambiguous two-way arms embargo. No Canadian manufactured weapons should be used to kill any innocent civilians. And there must be no loopholes such as shipping weapons via the United States. I welcome the recent comments by the Global Affairs Minister regarding an arms embargo, but I am asking the government for a clear statement that brokers no confusion, a clear and unambiguous two-way arms embargo. No qualifications or exceptions or asterisks for existing contract. And we must go further still. Madam Speaker, calling for a ceasefire and an arms embargo are the least Canadians expect. Let us look at the on-the-record public comments of Netanyahu and his cabinet, who have a habit of saying the quiet part out loud. On Israeli TV, Education Minister Yoav Kish said Lebanon and Hezbollah are indistinguishable. Lebanon will be annihilated, and the people of Lebanon will pay the price. This is the latest in a pattern of disgusting and dangerous comments by Netanyahu ministers. Deputy Speaker Nassim Vatour called to wipe Gaza off the face of the earth and added, Gaza must be burned. He went on to say, there are no innocents in Gaza, and referring to the Palestinian people, said, I have no mercy for those who are still there. We need to eliminate them. These are just few examples of many. These are not the words of the government that Canada can call a friend or ally. Canada cannot be accepting of pro-genocide comments by any government. Officials advocating for genocide must be banned from entering Canada, and there must be sanctions against a Netanyahu government that refuses to even consider peace. Last week at the United Nations, Jordanian Foreign Minister Ayman Safadi said that Arab and Muslim countries will guarantee Israel's security if Israel agrees to the establishment of a Palestinian state. This proposal was diminished outright by Netanyahu. He has shown no willingness to achieve a just peace that will bring safety and security for Palestinians, Israelis, and Lebanese. It is past time for Canada to recognize the Palestinian state. It doesn't need to be studied in committee. The government can stand up today in this house or outside and declare that Canada recognizes the Palestinian state. This would show that Canada believes in the right of self-determination for all people, and it would send a clear message to Netanyahu ministers that want to wipe Gaza off the face of the earth. Canada will not stay silent in the face of the genocide. Madam Speaker, I also worry deeply for the impact this conflict is having on people here in Canada. It is tearing communities apart. I see the rising incidence of anti-Palestinian racism, Islamophobia, and anti-Semitism. And I worry about the walls being built between Canadians. This cannot continue. I want peace for the people of Lebanon, of Palestine, of Israel. It's really very important that we make sure that this conflict does not further increase anti-Palestinian racism, anti-Semitism, or Islamophobia here in Canada. I've heard from Canadians, from Scarborough to Vancouver this summer, on anti-Palestinian racism, and I have heard it very clearly that this needs to end. I want peace for the people of Lebanon, of Palestine, and of Israel. I urge Canada to use all its diplomatic tools, including sanctions, to exert pressure for an end to this conflict. Too many innocent civilians have already paid with their lives. And if this is allowed to continue, many more will die as well. It needs to end. We need to make sure that the civilian lives, innocent lives, are protected. We have seen enough of it. Thank you, Madam Speaker.